This is Paul McKenna for PT Box 9 here today down in Birmingham with me, the brother number two, or brother number one, Carl Yafai. How are you, mate?
Okay, yeah, I'm good, thank you.
Sound, mate. Obviously, press conference done and dusted now, finished. First time you got to see your opponent.
Yeah.
What do you make of him up to now? I thought he was a bit quiet at first, but he seemed to have a little bit to say on the table, and he wants revenge.
Yeah, so. He wants revenge, fucking hell. I think he got, it's the fifth one I'm going to box, so he's going to want revenge, but I just can't see it happening. I just cannot see it happening. I'm in great shape. I always am, but I'm really in great shape. You know, I'm sharp, I'm firing all cylinders, I'm ready to go.
Yeah.
And I've got to make an example of this kid, and I'm sure I will.
Obviously, a lot of people are saying that this could be your toughest fight of the day. Do you see it that way?
Depends what happens on the night. You just never know in boxing, but to be honest with you, I don't think anyone really expects him to give me any trouble.
Yeah.
If anything, it might be a bit jumpy and awkward early on in the fight, the first three or four rounds. But after that, I think he'll start tiring, he'll start slowing down, and I think when I start slowing down my feet, planting my feet a bit more, I think the power's gonna really come through.
Yeah, obviously. I don't know if you've left it down to the coach, but as far as it goes, yourself, have you studied any of his fights? Have you seen any of his previous fights?
I've watched a bit of him. I always do. I always watch a bit of him. My trainers always make sure I watch a bit of him. Even if I say that, oh, that's fine. You watch him. They're like, nah, you have a look. They want to make sure I have a look as well. But I've had a look at him. They've had a look at him. Come up with different game plans, just in case anything happens. You know, you just never know in boxing. Like I said, anything could happen. But I know what I've got to do. On Saturday, and I'll solely concentrate on just doing the job on him and just boxing him.
That's it.
Stick to my boxing, and whatever comes off.
I know, as obviously Eddie has just mentioned up there, he's already sort of been in discussions with Kono for a possible fight in the summer. He's been out and seen him himself ringside. Obviously, everyone knows he's a good fighter, but that's the level that you want to be at, and obviously get Saturday night out the way, move on to bigger and better things.
Yeah, that's it. I've said to Eddie, after this, I want a big fight, and I want a world title fight, and I'm sure he'll deliver. But I'm solely concentrating on this kid first. I've got to do a job on him.
Yeah.
I can't take my eyes off the ball, and when I do a job on him, then I'll have a little breather, have a rest, because I've been training for a long time, so I need a good breather, and then in the summer I'm ready to go.
That's it. Obviously, your brother as well, Gamal, fighting on the bill, first sort of major fight for him in his career, for the Commonwealth title. I've just spoke to him. He's confident that it's going to be two Yafai wins on Saturday night, and I'm sure you're very confident of that as well.
Yeah, very confident. It's going to be two big wins. He's had brilliant prep. He's had some brilliant sparring with lots of Carl Frampton and Gavin McDonald. The lads up in Sheffield, the GB lads. You can't beat that kind of sparring, and it's got him in great nick, and I'm sure he'll do a really good number on this kid.
That's it. Okay, mate, well, on that note, I'll let the Nicaraguan Slayer get back to his business.
Back to chilling.
That's it.
Out till tomorrow.
That's it. Best of luck Saturday night, mate.
Thanks a lot, and I appreciate it.
Thank you.